There's hardly no one there.
Thank you.
Good evening. Merry Christmas. The Lord be with you. And welcome to what promises to be a Christmas Eve like no other, as so many other things this year have been at Protestant Community Church. We're delighted for those of you who've joined us here in person, and we're delighted for those who are joining us tonight by live stream. A few announcements as we get started. As you were shown to your seats as you came in, you will also be escorted from your seats when you depart the building tonight. So we'll simply ask you, as the recessional plays, that you stay in place and wait for an usher to come and tell you to leave. If there is someone here that you see that you would like to say Merry Christmas to this evening, we are happy for you to do that, but we simply ask that you get clear of the front door so as not to jam up the traffic, that you socially distance yourself appropriately and remain masked as you do so. If you have an offering to leave this evening, there is a basket at the front door, or you can simply hand that to one of the ushers as you leave if you've not had that opportunity to do so. And once the crowd clears, some of you may have offering envelopes for the coming year that you can pick up this evening. This is a modified time of lessons and carols tonight, and as we prepare to hear those carols and celebrate many of the stories behind them, I would invite you now to join me in prayer. Gracious God, loving Father, creator and sustainer of each of us, we're thankful this evening for the gift of Christ, for how he comes among us and shows us precisely who you are, as well as showing us what it means to be fully human. Bless our time together this evening. May we truly hear the message of Christmas and what is done in this place. These things we pray in the name of Christ, our Lord. Amen. Christmas is a time of music, a holiday that has its own special songs, songs that are beloved by many. Did you know that this was true of the first Christmas as well? According to the Gospel of Luke, there are four significant songs that surround the birth of Christ. The song of Mary, his mother. The song of Zechariah, the father of John the Baptist. The song of the angels. And the song of the old man, Simeon. Tonight, as we listen to some of our favorite songs of Christmas, we will reflect on these first hymns that celebrated the birth of Christ as Emmanuel, God with us. The Gospel of Luke tells us that this is Mary's song. Mary said, "I'm bursting with good news from God. I'm dancing the song of my Savior, God. God took one good look at me, and look what happened. I am the most fortunate woman on earth. What God has done for me will never be forgotten. The God whose very name is holy, set apart from all others, his mercy flows in wave after wave on those who are in awe before the Lord. The Lord bared his arm and showed his strength, scattered the bluffing braggarts, knocked tyrants off of their high horses, pulled victims out of the mud. The starving poor sat down to a banquet. The callous rich were left out in the cold. The Lord embraced his chosen child, Israel. He remembered and piled on mercies, piled them high. It's exactly what he promised to do, beginning with Abraham up until now." Mary's song is often called the Magnificat, reflecting her declaration that her soul magnifies the Lord. Mary's song is an expression of humility, as well as a song of joy. Mary recognizes the blessing of God, as well as the continued important place in history that she will occupy. She reflects on the power of God to bless the humble and humble the arrogant. Mary's song challenges us with its message. The song asks of us, does your soul magnify the Lord your Creator? Does God's desire to use your life prompt humility and joy within you? Do you give thanks to God for acting in ways that bless the humble and humble the arrogant? The essence of Mary's song is captured in the hymn, What Child Is This? Reflect now as Sandy plays, What Child Is This? Luke also tells us the story of Zechariah, the father of John the Baptist. Luke chapter 1, verses 67 to 79. Zechariah was filled with the Holy Spirit and prophesied, "Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He came and set his people free. He set the power of salvation in the center of our lives and in the very house of David his servant, just as he promised long ago through the preaching of his holy prophets, deliverance from our enemies and every hateful hand, mercy to our fathers as he remembers to do what he said he'd do, what he swore to our father Abraham, a clean rescue from the enemy camp, so we can worship God without a care in the world, made holy before him as long as we live. And you, my child, prophet of the highest, will go ahead of the Master to prepare his way. Present the offer of salvation to his people, the forgiveness of their sins. Through the heartfelt mercies of God, God's sunrise will break in upon us, shining on those in the darkness, those sitting in the shadow of death, then showing us the way, one foot at a time, down the path of peace." We've all lived recently in a time of muted and unmuted, just as did Zechariah, the father of John the Baptist. Muted because of his utter disbelief at the beginning of his wife Elizabeth's pregnancy. When he is unmuted, he offers the song of hope that you just heard, reflecting on the role his son will play in the future of Messiah's mission. Zechariah sings of the goodness of God, who keeps promises to the people of God. He sings of his son's role as the one who prepares the way of the promised Messiah by teaching forgiveness, by bringing light into the darkness, and guiding people to peace. Zechariah's song challenges us in this season by asking us to probe our own unmuted opportunities with these questions. Do we believe in a God who keeps his promises? If so, how have we experienced such? And how have we shared such with others? How do we teach and offer the forgiveness of which Zechariah sings? How do we bring light into the darkness? How are we instruments of God's peace in the midst of conflict? The message of Zechariah's son, John the Baptist, is captured in the ancient classic hymn, Angels from the Realms of Glory, a hymn that, like the message of John, calls all who will listen to come and worship. Reflect now as you listen to Angels from the Realms of Glory. And along with Mary and Zechariah, the angels did sing of Christ's birth. Listen now to the song of the angels from Luke chapter 2, verses 10 through 14. There were sheep herders camping in the neighborhood. They had set night watches over their sheep. Suddenly, God's angel stood among them, and God's glory blazed around them. They were terrified. The angel said to them, "Don't be afraid. I'm here to announce a great and joyful event that is meant for everybody worldwide. A Savior has just been born in David's town, a Savior who is Messiah and Master. This is what you're to look for, a baby wrapped in a blanket and lying in a manger." At once the angel was joined by a huge angelic choir, singing praises to God. Glory to God in the heavenly heights. peace to all men and women on earth who please him. The angels appeared to the shepherds to disclose the good news of Christ's birth, the promise that in Bethlehem they would find the long-awaited Messiah. In the midst of their announcement, they break into a hymn of praise to God that promises peace to those God favors. The announcement and the song of the angels challenge us in this season to ask of ourselves, do we have a message of good news to share with those who need good news? What are we willing to do in order to offer that message to others? Do we take the time to glorify God and seek God's favor so that we might be instruments of God's peace to the world? Would the good news we share with others cause them to act as the shepherds did that night? Seeking Christ and offering praise to God, they abandoned everything but the sheep that they took with them. The essence of the angel song is captured in our hymn, "Angels We Have Heard on High," while the shepherd's response is captured in the classic hymn, "Go Tell It on the Mountain." Reflect now on these two classic hymns of Christmas. There was an ancient sage of sorts named Simeon, and a prophetess, she's called, named Anna, who apparently spent most of their time at the temple. And Simeon has a hymn included in Luke's story. Simeon's hymn is Luke chapter 2, verses 10 through 14. No, it's not either. Simeon's hymn is Luke chapter 2, verses 25 through 35. In Jerusalem at the time, there was a man named Simeon, a good man, a man who had lived in prayerful expectancy of help for Israel. And the Holy Spirit was with him. The Holy Spirit had shown him that he would see the Messiah of God before he died. Led by the Spirit, he entered the temple. As the parents of the child Jesus brought him in to carry out the rituals of the law, Simeon took him into his arms and blessed God. God, you can now release your servant. Release me in peace as you promised. With my own eyes, I have seen your salvation. It's now out in the open for everyone to see. A God-revealing light to the non-Jewish nations and the glory for your people, Israel. Jesus' father and mother were speechless with surprise at the words of Simeon. And Simeon went on to bless them and said to Mary, his mother, "This child marks both the failure and the recovery of many in Israel. A figure misunderstood and contradicted, the pain of a sword thrust through you, but the rejection will force honesty as God reveals who they really are." Luke tells us that Simeon was a devout person, a person, as you heard, who was promised life until he saw the arrival of God's Messiah. The promise was fulfilled at the temple dedication of Jesus, for which Simeon offered a hymn of gratitude, declaring that he had seen the promise of God, which would become a blessing of God to all people. Simeon's hymn of satisfaction with the promise of God challenges us at several points. Do we have the same patience that Simeon had to wait on the promises of God, no matter how long it takes? Are we conscious of the need to thank God when God keeps promises that are made to us? Do we affirm with Simeon the desire of God to reach all people through Christ? Do we feel that that desire is a good thing? Or are there people we would like to exclude from God's mercy in Christ? Simeon's song reminds me of the pleading hymn of Advent, O come, Emmanuel. Reflect now as you listen to O come, Emmanuel. So now you've heard from Luke the earliest hymns of Christmas, the hymn of a mother, the hymn of a father, the hymn of the angels, and the hymn of an ancient Hebrew man. They all find resonance in one of our favorite hymns of Christmas, originally written for the guitar when the cathedral organ could not be repaired in time for Christmas. But our organ is working tonight, so reflect now on the hymn, Silent Night, Holy Night. This hymn challenges us to let the night be just that in our lives. So now it's your turn. There may be some Christmas hymns that you've not gotten to hear in this rather unprecedented season. And for a few moments, Sandy has agreed to play at least one verse of the hymns that you would request. I'll start over here. I see a hand in the back. Lisa?
Away in the Manger.
Away in the Manger. I think she knows that one.
Thank you.
Now it's your turn. Nobody has anything over here? We'll go back over here. Schaefer family has one. Hark the Herald Angels Sing. Camille? Oh, come all ye faithful. Holy Night. And then I've got one over here. There was a hand over here somewhere, right?
Joy to the world.
Joy to the world. That's all? Oh, little town of Bethlehem? I see a hand back there, Nancy. Ave Maria, I think she knows that one too.
I don't have that.
You don't have that? Well, we'll have to pass on that one. You stumped the band, so. Okay. Lo, how a rose there blooming. That one is there, I think. That's technically Advent, Camille, but we did an Advent hymn tonight already, so. Okay, hearing nothing else, then I'll offer you a benediction, and remember after the benediction to stay in place until you are directed by the usher to leave. And also remember, if you wish to say Merry Christmas, to get clear of the door, maintain social distance and masking, and we'd love for you to do that. Receive this word of benediction and blessing. And now as you go into the world believing that the Christ of Christmas will bring you the hope, peace, joy, and love that your life needs and that you can share with a world that needs such. Go in goodness, go in grace, go in peace. Amen.
think there's a...